Hypersonic flight, or flying faster than 5 times the speed of sound, is a cutting-edge field in aerospace engineering, both for high-speed aircraft and spacecraft as they enter the atmosphere from orbit, which is a necessary step in interplanetary travel. One challenge is that the gas surrounding the vehicle gets really hot. We can mitigate this heating with thermal protection systems, but they can be easily damaged, resulting in failure. So let's talk about thermal protection systems, or heat shields. There are a huge variety of ways heat shields can be designed, depending on the temperatures and amount of time the vehicle is exposed to heat. However, one thing most of them have in common is that they are made of lightweight, low-density materials in order to save weight, which can make them prone to damage. When a high-speed flow encounters an area of damage, the flow in that area can change direction or even become turbulent, which can cause more heating in that area. Depending on the size and geometry of the damage, this can result in a failure of the heat shield. An example of this is the Columbia tragedy, when the orbiter failed during re-entry due to damage on the heat shield. Pictured here is a simulation of the Mars sample return capsule that I ran using the computational fluid solver US3D. You can see how there's recirculation of the flow inside the damaged area. From my simulation, we can see that there's increased heating near the damaged region. By doing more research like this, both through simulations and high-speed wind tunnel testing, we can figure out how to design heat shields so that they won't fail, even if they do have certain types of damage. Another solution is to prevent the damage from occurring in the first place. We can engineer ways to protect vehicles while they're on the ground, and even while they're traveling through space. We can also design our spacecraft to be deorbited at the end of their lifetime, to reduce the growing amount of space junk in Earth orbit and protect future vehicles. I'm Emma Lenz, I'm an aerospace engineering student at the University of Minnesota, and I think that more people should get involved with hypersonics because it's really cutting edge, and who doesn't love to go fast? Thank you!